Now we want to study thread methods. Thread names can be set and get using set name and get name methods. The syntax of it is public final void set name. We can provide the parameter, that is string name. It changes the name of this thread to be equal to the argument name. What it does? First, the check access method of this thread is called with no arguments. This may result in throwing the security exception. Parameters name, the new name for this thread. It throws security exception if the current thread cannot modify this thread. Other method is public final string get name, which returns this thread's name. Public final void check access, this method determines if the currently running thread has permission to modify this thread. If there is a security manager, its check access method is called with this thread as its argument. This may result in throwing a security exception. Public string toString, this method returns a string representation of this thread, including the thread's name, priority, and thread group. It overrides toString of the object class. Static integer active count, this method returns an estimate of the number of active threads in the current threads, thread group, and its subgroups. Static thread current thread, it returns a reference to the currently executing thread object. Static map thread comma stack trace element array, get all stack traces, it returns a map of stack traces for all live threads. Long get id, it returns the identifier of this thread. Thread.state get state, it returns the state of this thread, that is whether it is new or terminated or time waiting or blocked, etc. Void join, it waits for this thread to die. After it, the thread state will be terminated. Void join, long milliseconds, it waits at most milliseconds for this thread to die. Void join, long millis, comma integer nanos, waits at most milliseconds plus nanoseconds for this thread to die. After the join method, the thread enters into terminated state. Is alive, it tests if this thread is alive or not. Void setDaemon boolean on marks this thread as either a daemon thread or a user thread. Daemon threads are the threads which runs in the background. Boolean is daemon, it tests if this thread is a daemon thread or not. Boolean is interrupted tests whether this thread has been interrupted or not.